like to give all praise, honor, and glory to Yahweh Bashim Yahweh. Peace and safety to the hopefully elect, all the sincere Akim scattered throughout the four corners, pushing his word in sincerity and in truth. And for those who don't know, Yahweh is the name of the Heavenly Father, who the world ignorantly calls God. And Yahweh is the name of the only begotten Son, who the world ignorantly calls Jesus Christ. And this is another edition of Biblical Interpretations. And in this edition, I'm going to go into the book of Romans, chapter 11 and verse 26. And when it reads, "And so all Israel shall be saved." I'm going to show you through the precept that this all is not referring to the whole nation of Israel. According to the Christians, and they bugged out doctrine, God so loved the world, referring to everybody on earth, which we know that's complete madness. And according to what those teach amongst the circumcision, that this is referring to the whole nation of Israel. But I'm going to show you through the precept that this is only referring to the elect. All right, that same world in John 3:16 that believeth on the only begotten Son, Yahweh. So it says, "And so all Israel shall be saved." Now I want to get a precept in the book of Isaiah and show you what that all is referring to. So this is the book of Isaiah, chapter 45 and verse 17. And it reads, "But Israel shall be saved in the Lord with an everlasting salvation." Now we know salvation is only for the elect. All right, reading on, "Ye shall not be ashamed." And we know according to the book of Daniel, let's get it right quick. The book of Daniel, chapter 12 and verse 2, it says, "And many of them," referring to Israelites, "that sleep in the dust of the earth shall awake, some to everlasting life and some to shame." All right, so that lets you know that this is not referring to all Israel, man. All right, that's only referring to all the elect. So it says, "And some to shame and everlasting contempt." Now, going back to the book of Isaiah 45:17, it says, "But Israel shall be saved." Now we know that Israel is referring to all the elect of Israel. "In the Lord with an everlasting salvation, ye shall not be ashamed," because we know some are going to wake up to shame, man. All right, "in everlasting contempt." All right, so that's all is not referring to the whole nation, it's referring to all the elect. Okay. So let's see here. It says, "Ye shall not be ashamed nor confounded, world without end." And that's the same world referred to in John 3:16, man. All right. Not everybody on the planet, such as these bugged out Christians, man. All right. Teach, man. All right. So going back to the book of Romans, chapter 11 and verse 26, it says, "And so all Israel shall be saved." Now we know this all is referring to all the elect. "As it is written, there shall come out of Zion the deliverer, and shall take away ungodliness from Jacob." And Jacob is referring to the elect. All right, remember, those who are not, who don't believe in Yahweh Shai, the Lord said, "Count them as a heathen." All right, they're going to be part of that body of water, that lake. All right, that body of people that's going to be judged, which is referred to as the lake of fire. So this all is only referring to the elect. And let's prove that further. Stay in the book of Romans, chapter 9, verse 27, it says, Isaiah also cried concerning Israel, "Though the number of the children of Israel be as the sand of the sea, a remnant shall be saved." Now, let's look up this word remnant. You see, it says remains, It says a few. All right. Remember, some gonna awake to everlasting shame. And that's referring to Israel, man. All right. So all Israel is not going to be saved. This is only referring to the elect. So it says, Isaiah also cried concerning Israel, though the number of the children of Israel be as the sand of the sea, a remnant, only a remnant, a few, shall be saved. For he will finish the work and cut it short in righteousness, because a short work will the Lord make upon the earth. All right? So this is talking about the Lord returning, making short work of the earth when he bring the destruction, man. All right? Verse 9. And as Isaiah said before, except the Lord of Sabaoth. And that Sabaoth, when you look it up, meaning the Lord of armies, man. All right? Let's see here. The Lord of Sabaoth, the Lord of the armies. The Lord of the armies. It said, as those who are under the leadership of the protection of Yahweh maintain his cause of war. Referring to the elect, man. Alright. It says armies, military. Alright. So that's what that's referring to. It says, has left us a seed, a few. We have been as Sodom and have been like unto Gomorrah. So the Lord is likening you Israelites, alright, you wicked Israelites, as to Sodom and Gomorrah, man. Alright. So it says, but that's the point on that. Now, let's go back to the book of Romans 11 and read that without any private interpretations, man. Romans 11, 26, Salakia. And read that without any private interpretations. So it says, and so all Israel, referring to all the elect, shall be saved, that remnant, that few, as it is written, there shall come out of Zion a deliverer, referring to Yahweh Shai, and shall take away ungodliness from Jacob. For this is my covenant unto them, and the them is referring to all Israel, that elect, that few, that remnant, when I shall take away their sins. As concerning the gospel, the good news, they are enemies for our sake. But as touching the election, the elect, man, that world, let's look up this word. It says the act of picking out, chosen. All right, remember, few are called, many are called, but few are chosen. And that's the elect, the same world in John 3:16. Of the act of the power, free will, by which before the foundation of the world decreed, is blessing to certain persons, not everybody. All right, so these bugged out Christians teaching that God so loved everybody on earth is a lie, man. All right, so it says a thing or person chosen of person, the Most High's elect. All right, the Most High elect, and that's what it's referring to, and that's who this Bible is for. So if you are not part of that chosen and elect, you're not going to be delivered, man. All right? You're not going to be saved. Salvation is not pertaining to you, man. All right? So, let's see here. Let's go back. So, it says, as concerning the gospel, which is the good news, they are enemies for our sake. But as touching the election, the elect, that few, they are beloved for the Father's sake. And that's what it's referring to, and that's the biblical interpretation of the book of Romans chapter 11, 26. Is not referring to the whole nation of Israel, man. Alright, it's referring to the elect, the chosen, the few, that world that believeth in Yahweh Shai, man. Alright, remember, some are going to wake up, and that some, referring to you Israelites, are going to wake up to everlasting shame and contempt, man. Alright, so that all is only referring to the elect. And with that, I'm going to say Shalom.